Well, warm greetings, everyone. This is Pastor Ray Durkin in my office here at First Baptist Church in Lakeview, Oregon. And today is Tuesday, April the 14th, 2020. Today, I'd like to bring you a short report on our experience with drive-in church. This past Sunday, we observed Resurrection Sunday, and for the first time in the history of our church, did drive-in church. I just want to say that really more than a report, this is a time to give praise and thanks to God. It was truly a wonderful time. So many people contributed in so many different ways to make drive-in church happen. And we just want to give praise and glory to God for this blessed experience that we had. So I hope you enjoy this video montage that will give you a taste of drive-in church at First Baptist Church on Resurrection Sunday, April the 12th, 2020. Resurrection Sunday. We are delighted that you are here. Thanks for making the effort. You probably noticed in your bulletin, if not, it is First Baptist Drive-In Church. Amen. Honk honk. I hear that honk. Okay. Well, we thought of everything except cookies. That was the number one item that was mentioned. Where are the cookies? We forgot the cookies. We are very, very appreciative. There have been a number of people that have contributed in various ways to make this possible this morning. First of all, everybody look at Casey. Hey, Casey. All right. This was Casey's brainchild. And so I've been telling people, if everything goes well, I will take credit. If everything heads south, it's Casey's fault. So express your appreciation to Casey, would you? All right. All right, isn't this fun? So if your battery dies by the end of the service, we will give you a jump start, okay? We're ready to do that. So, Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep.
Since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man.
Amen. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for this beautiful day. We thank you for the opportunity to gather in this way to be reminded that the church is not a building, but the church is people. And Father, as we desperately need a relationship with you, we need relationship with one another. And I am grateful that we can express our love for you and for one another as we gather here in this place.
Christ the Lord is risen today, alleluia. Sons of men and angels say, alleluia. Raise your joys and triumphs high, alleluia. Sing ye heavens and earth reply, alleluia.
Mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, but the former things have passed away. So Paul continues this contrast, verse 43. The temporal physical body is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. Jesus. Wow. As we come to observe the table today, it is to remember his sacrifice, to remember the Lord's resurrection. Well, this is a special way for us to remember and to celebrate Christ's sacrifice on the cross. And as Jesus commanded us, we do this in remembrance of him. I would like you to open the first part of your communion set. I'd like to read to you from Matthew 26 and verse 26. And now as they were eating the Passover, Jesus took bread and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Lord, I thank you for this very simple ceremony that helps us to remember your sacrifice on the cross, that you willingly gave your body as a sacrifice for our sins. We acknowledge you gladly today, Lord Jesus, as our substitute, that in your body you bore our sins on the cross. Lord, thank you for your sacrifice on our behalf. Verse 27, Jesus took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." Lord Jesus, as we partake of this cup, we understand that without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sins. But Lord, you gladly gave your life, shed your blood, in order that we might experience the forgiveness of God. And now, Lord Jesus, we take this cup in remembrance of your sacrifice with great thanksgiving in our hearts, eternal thanksgiving that you have died in our place. And we thank you in your precious name. Amen.
You don't have to stand for the last song.
God sent his son, they called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. because he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future.
Awesome. We're going to pray. After we pray, we want our middle row to leave first, follow the directions of our parking lot attendants. Pays to be a back row Baptist. The back row gets to go second. Let's pray. Father God, what a glorious day. Thank you so much for the opportunity to come here, to be here together, celebrating the resurrection of Jesus Christ. As we have contemplated your death, your resurrection, we also anticipate your soon return. Lord, may we be found waiting, watching, and working when you come. May you be glorified as we continue to serve you. Father, I ask your blessing on each one here today. They've made a special effort to be here. May they go forth in joy as they face the journey of their life, knowing that you walk with them. I pray in Jesus' precious name. Amen. All right, middle row, start your engines.